Did you always think, like, okay, like, I'm going to win the Olympics one day? Because, I mean, I started day one being like, okay, I want to win the Olympics in this, like, the first day that I did it. Or was there, like, a day that it dawned on you that, hey, I'm really something special?
I wasn't a bad I was just a nice kid, and I had to learn how to toughen up. In high school, I wanted to be a state champion. I became a state champion. In college, I wanted to be NCAA champion. I became an NCAA champion. So I set these goals at every level I went to. Mm-hmm. I didn't look further ahead and say, I'm going to win Olympic gold medal. And when, after I won my second NCAA title, I knew the Olympics were in my grasp.
Typically, anything in Kurt's grasp does not escape. But the Olympics almost slipped away.
I was at the US Open. I got thrown on my head, and I heard every bone in my neck crack and crunch. Oh. And I got up, and I couldn't feel my arms. So I went back to Pittsburgh and went to a doctor, and he said I broke four vertebrae in my neck, and
oh,
I got two discs that are lodged directly in my spinal cord. And I'm risking paralysis. So I wasn't going to be cleared to wrestle in the Olympic trials in the Olympics unless I got this doctor to clear me. He had a doctor go with me to the trials, and the doctor would shoot me with 12 shots of Novocaine in my neck, so I couldn't feel the pain. And that's how I got through the Olympic trials. You know, 5 minutes before my match, the doctor would stick me with 12 shots. I'd go out and wrestle, I couldn't feel it.
Wow.
And then an hour later, I'd be in excruciating pain. So it was a good and bad trade-off, but it was worth it. It got me wrestling in the Olympics, and I won Olympic gold medal. So I don't regret the decision I made, and I would do it over again if I had to.